Hello, welcome to Lenze Training. This tutorial shows how to connect and assign digital and analog inputs and outputs by using the PLC Designer. In this example, a project named PLC base PRG is opened. The controller 3200C serves as PLC device. When selecting Visu underscore project, a basic machine diagram is displayed. In this example, empty containers are filled up with ingredients. The container comes from the left side and is filled up as soon as it is detected by the sensor. When this is done, the container is passed on to next conveyor belt. The speed of the conveyor belt can be controlled through an analog speed set point. There are available three digital inputs. B1 is the container detected signal. S1 is the manual valve open command through push button. And B2 is the container filling done feedback. S2 is the conveyor speed set point, which is the analog input. There are available three digital outputs. Q1 is conveyor halt, Q2 is the conveyor run command, and Q3 is the valve open command. Finally, there is one analog output. K1 is the target velocity. Right-click on application and select Add Object, then select Global Variable List. Name it GVL underscore input and press the Add button. On top of the variable list, the attribute qualified only is indicated. This pragma has the effect that variables from a global variable list can only be accessed by specifying the global variable list name. If the pragma is deleted, the variable will be assigned based on the variable name only. This can result in ambiguities and unintended shadowing with local variables. Write input variables in the variable list. Note that direct addressing mode is used for writing the third input variable. Again, right-click on Application and select Add Object. Then select Global Variable List and name it GVL underscore output. Finally, press the Add button. Write output variables in the variable list. Note that direct addressing mode is used for writing the third output variable. Assign input and output variables to hardware. Select any of the I/O modules and then go to the Module I/O Mapping tab. Map the inputs and outputs with the help of the Input Assistant. Do it in the same way for all I/O modules. Go to the Online tab and select Login. Then confirm the warning message to download the project. Go to the Debug tab and select Start to enable the controller. Observe to the global variable list while simulating the inputs and outputs. Check the functionality of each variable. Go to the Online tab and select Logout to go offline. Go to the File tab and select Save Project to finally save the project on your local drive.